And just, and the worst part is, as an auditor, our OT is really very long. And you have OT, but you don't have OT pay. So it's very, very sad. So if you minus, divide the hours and the money, I'm very lowly paid. Worse than McDonald's staff. But I am called an auditor. Sounds very nice. Sounds very prestigious. But the pocket, nothing. So I ask myself, is that something I want to continue? The answer is no. So this story is very long, and I will not go on. But that's the reason why I landed here. And today the topic about, just now Venus already mentioned. So in Q3, Q3 is now, right, the third quarter of the year, 2000 retrenchment. So if you look at this, in Q, this was what I found on the news, China News Asia. In quarter two, of course, retrenchment also increased. Quarter three, 2,000 people. And another news is this from IBM. People feel that they are not very happy with the retrenchment. So I want to share with you a real life story about one of my close friends. So when this happened quite a few years back, so I have a very close friend. He is very, very smart. So when we were all in university, right, he's always the top student. So when he graduated, the first company he went to is OCBC. And at OCBC, he was one of the top management for a junior position. So he was working US hours. You know what I mean? So it's opposite from our timing. So when he was working, right, every time when we are off work, you know, people here, you're in the early 20s, you know what I mean? After work, where do you go? Drink. Who say drink? Go home? 20 plus. 20 plus don't go home, man. 20 plus don't go home. They go and drink. 30 plus, you go home. 30 plus, confirm at home. Okay? So when I was in the 20 plus, right, after working, right, we always go and drink. And my friend, right, he always drinks with us. Normally we drink until 12 a.m. And then we go home. But where he go? Work. He go back and work, no? So his hours, everything was already jumbled up. And then at that time, I was already in Usana. So he's a very good friend of mine. So I said, bro, look, you need to take fish oil. At least, because you're working this kind of hour, right, you confirm will have issues with your cholesterol and blood flow. And he says, siao ah, you 20 plus eat fish oil? No, it's not for me. So anyway, long story short, one day we're supposed to visit his family for Chinese New Year that year. But we received a message from another friend that he will not be able to attend to us because he's in the hospital and because he has stroke. That year, we were only 27 and he had stroke. When he had stroke, he was in the hospital lying there recovering. When he recovered after 3 months and he headed back to office, guess what? His boss told him, we are very sorry, but while you were away, we found someone else who could do the things that you are doing. So maybe you can find another place. Retrenchment. Goodbye. So, you know, it feels very sad. And then, you know, he actually had depression after that. Because he bought, at the age of 27, he bought himself a BMW. And he was very, very proud of his car. And he was paying installment. When he had stroke, when he was retrenched from his job, he couldn't pay for his car. So suddenly it was a very big shift in his ego and he had depression for the next 1 year. Today he's much better. But when we always think about this story, right, I always ask myself, everyone we work so hard for the job, but why are we working so hard for a job that can replace you tomorrow? And eventually this job you're working is for someone else, it's not your own. So retrenchment is very realistic, right? It's very real, right? So imagine this, why are we working so hard? And the thing is, today's world, right, especially in Singapore, right, everything is very expensive, right? Do you all think Singapore is expensive?
Yes.
How many people here are not Singaporeans, you're foreigners? Do you all like Singapore? Yes, huh? Why do you like Singapore? Can you go to Disneyland? But Singapore is expensive, right? A typical Singaporean, right? A husband and wife. We talk about, so okay, whatever I'm going to share right here, right? It's just a general illustration. Of course, it can be adjusted according to your own group of people. An average Singaporean doing pretty well, normally the husband and wife earns 5k each, for example. So that combined together, your combined family household income is 10k. Let's say if you are 28 years old and you're earning 10k a month, it's a lot of money, right? It's not too bad, right? But if you consider the expenses that we have, again, these are illustrations depending on what kind of lifestyle you want to have. Okay, let's take a look at this. House, 3,000. This depends on what kind of house you have. Of course, if you want to cut costs, you can stay in HDB. But if you want to lead a better life, you want to stay in condo, 3K is average. The house I have right now, right, is way more than this. And house itself is already, every month I earn, right, the money straight away, a few thousand dollars is gone, goodbye, because it's mortgage. So it depends on what house you stay in. Let's say you stay in a house where you're paying 3K a month. Let's say if you don't want to take MRT, you want to take, you want to drive a car. A Japanese car is around 1K, and this 600, I pay about this 600. This is your parking fee, your ERP, and sometimes you're fine. When I'm driving, right, I always have fine. It's like I just count it into my cost. I count it into my regular expenses. It just always happens. You don't know why? Sometimes ERP, you didn't put a card, and then you're late. And then just because you didn't put a card, and somehow two ERP happens at the same time. And then DDD, 150 bucks gone. And then if you want, that's the cost of Singapore. Welcome. Right? Child, okay, if you have a kid, you know Singapore, right? Nowadays, a lot of young couples, they don't have kids. Why? Expensive. Kids very cute, but expensive. One child. So some of you are parents here. I think you will tell me that this is a very low amount, 1,500. And it depends again on what kind of life you want to give to your child, right? If your child wants to, recently I heard a very funny story. So I met this lady, she's in her 40s. Family, husband is very rich. So she is like tai-tai. So, but she's very busy. Every day she's just busy fetching her son to different kind of courses and picking him up. So I asked her, what kind of classes does her son take? The son is 10 years old. 10 years old is primary 4. Right. The son learns golf. Yes, golf. You say, oh, golf very good. Golf, your son learn golf, right? He focus. He learn to focus. Oh, I said, golf, okay. Never mind, golf. Then he learn basketball. Then he learn volleyball. Then, oh my god, another little beach ball. Basically, I ended by telling her, your son, as long as it's a ball, he has to learn every single kind of activity. And then he learns piano. And then he learns violin. In total, he's learning about 10 things. You think 1.5k enough? Maybe 15k? So it really depends on what kind of life they have, right? Elderly allowance, if you have to give your parents money. Food and drinks, again, this depends on what kind of lifestyle you want. Some people, one meal is already 200-300 easily every time. Right? So, yeah, it really depends, right, in Singapore. Insurance, and what if you want to have a saving for your year-end holiday. You add this together, you get 11,000. Then your earning is 10,000. So end up you are kind of like broke. Right? It's negative, right? So a lot of people in this world, they earn a lot. But the key here is not how much you earn. It's after you earn, right, and you spend, right, how much are you left with? That is the key. And what if your partner is retrenched suddenly? That means you minus all 5k, no? And that's when the real problem will arise. Okay, so that is the key thing. In Singapore, I always tell my friends, in Singapore, I'm not asking everybody here today after my talk go and quit your jobs. I'm not saying that. But I'm saying in Singapore, right, you have to be smart. You have to have an extra income. So that when something happens, you will not die. So that you have something, you have a backup here, you have a spare tire here. Something that still gives you an income when you are retrenched or when something, just something happened, okay? So you need to have an extra income. So I always ask people this question. Close your eyes right now. Okay, close your eyes please. I know you are all very tired from your job. So now, I give you 5 seconds to close your eyes. Imagine what is your perfect life. Okay, 5 seconds. Think about your perfect life. What is in your picture right now? Okay, open your eyes. Open. So you're still sleeping. Open really hard. So what is in your perfect life? What is in the picture? Holiday. What is in your picture? Holiday? Yourself?
Time freedom?
Do whatever you want? Sleep? You see, we always say the most beautiful thing in life to me, the most beautiful thing Rusana has given me is that I can wake up as and when I want. And I can sleep as and when I want. Sometimes I just sleep at 2 p.m. until 4 p.m. because I'm too free. So that is really the thing I will enjoy, because when I was working, I cannot sleep at 2 p.m. I have to work, right? So holiday, free time, what else? What else is in your perfect life? What else? What is in your perfect life? What's in the picture? Your wife?
Family time.
At any time?
Family time.
Oh.
Family
time. So if we sum all this up, right, actually it's just 3 things that we all want, right? We just want to have more time, right? More money, right? And more freedom, right? These are the things that we want to enjoy, right? But if you think about it, if you continue doing what you're doing right now at your job, will you achieve more money? Maybe. Will you achieve more time? No, never. Will you achieve more freedom? No, never. So you only have more money and a little bit, not a lot, right? So that's why we have to think about other avenues of income. So when I was in school, nobody taught me about this concept of income. When I was in school, right, everybody just know income to be linear. Linear income is very simple. Today, you work, and then you continue working every single day. At the end of the month, your boss gives you a paycheck. So that is your income. And we always say, everyone is overpaid in the beginning and underpaid as their experience increase. So imagine if you have worked for 20 years, and after 20 years, your income is 8K. But when you started as a junior, your income is 3K. So 3K to 8K is 5K increment in 20 years. So aren't you underpaid at 20 years mark? You are. So this is the problem. Linear income is always linear. It's a linear income one. So what I was very excited when I got to know about other options is that there's something known as a leveraged income. What is leveraged income? Everybody in this room, you have 24 hours a day. So no matter how smart you are, how talented you are, how productive you are only given 24 hours. And you can only earn up to that amount. Let's say if you're a salesman, let's say if you're doing insurance, every day you can only meet 5 clients, for example. Can you meet 50 clients a day? Cannot, right? So which means that your income is limited at that 5 clients. But what if you have a business where you can build an organization and you're building a network and everybody in your team can also meet 5 clients a day? And everybody in their team can also meet 5 clients a day. How many do you have right now? 50, yeah? 15? Oh yes, correct. So, and the story goes on and on, right? Imagine if your associate meets 5 and someone that he brings in meets 5 and it just goes on and on and on. It's amazing. It can go crazy. So this is something that we want, which is the power of leverage income. So that is why I got very, very interested in this industry of network marketing. So network marketing, you can give it a lot of different names. You can call it mail marketing, you can call it direct sales, you can also call it something very scary, three letters, MLM. Some people are very funny. When they hear the three letters MLM, they just go away. So if somebody whom you don't like, right, and you want to get rid of them, right, just tell them, I'm in MLM, without MLM. Right? It's very funny. I always tell people, why are you so scared of MLM? MLM, there are legit kind and non-legit kind. Everything in this world, there's also legit and non-legit. Right? Even in China, milk powder, there is a legit milk powder and there is a non-legit milk powder that if you eat, you will die. So the thing is doing your own research and not just closing our eyes and blindly saying no to this just because we heard an uncle who did MLM and who failed. And you don't even know who's uncle, no? Just I heard some uncle did this and he failed and so I'm not going to touch it. So it's about having the wisdom to do our own research. So now I prefer to call it network marketing because MLM is a word that can confuse a lot of people. Because effectively speaking, MLM is multi-level. And for you sana, in our context, right, we are called direct sales. Because multi-level, it means that most of the cases is where the company's product cost to different associates at different level is different price. That's why it's called a multi-level. So these are all the things that there's a difference in it, right? So network marketing is an industry where it's booming right now, and a lot of people are into this. In Singapore, we have more than 200 companies selling different kind of product. Basically, what this industry does is just like any kind of retail business that they sell product, just that the channel is through word of mouth. Instead of selling the product through having a physical shop, having a physical shelf, the channel is through physical, through people who are the real consumers and users of the products. So that is just a different channel. So now marketing, many companies are in this model. So even in Indonesia, do you know that companies selling clothes via this model? Yeah, so there's a lot of different kind of variations. And some people say that this industry is an industry for people who have no choice, no options in life. But let us take a look at some of the wise words from people who are experts. So someone once told me that anyone who is brought up is always very smart. And that I must agree. Because my father is also like this. And I always think that men who have no hair, they are very smart. Because they use too much brain and then always body right in the shape. Like. So this guy is called Thorsten Puser and he's an economist and he used to be an economist for Ronald Reagan and George Bush. So he's very famous and what he does is that he predicts the trend of the future. So if you're interested, you can Google him and find his videos on YouTube and you can learn more about his predictions. So what he predicted was that in the 1980s, where computers are still very big. So at that time, a computer is as big as half of a small room. And his prediction is that in 20 years later, every household will have at least one computer. So can you imagine people who are in the 1980s, they cannot see the future. And they are like, huh, the computer is so big, and you're saying that in the 20 years later, every house will have at least one there. Then everybody say this guy siao, crazy. But did it happen right now? It came true, right? Everybody, our handphone is a computer, right? Our handphone computer, and then we have our iPad, our laptop, and we have two handphones, three handphones. So we have already, it came true. So what was his next prediction? His next prediction was of two industries. One is the direct selling industry, and one is the wellness industry. So his prediction is that the future millionaires are all going to be coming from the wellness industry. Because this industry is industry where it's growing very, very fast. So later I'll share with you why. Some of the other experts who have been talking about this network marketing industry are as above, so you can read about them. So one of the person I really, really like is Robert Kiyosaki. So he's the author of Rich Dad Poor Dad. So how many of you here have read the book, Rich Dad Poor Dad? Not many. Okay, if you have not read this book, right, I will highly recommend you to read this book, Rich Dad Poor Dad. Because it really, really opens your mind about the concept about income and money. So he says that people who are rich always look for building network, whereas the poor people are always taught to look for a job. And it's indeed true. Can anyone become rich by working in a job for many, many years? No one became rich because of that. You see all the rich people, Jack Ma, who else? Steve Jobs, Bill Gates. All of them, they are doing their own business. They are building their own network, right? So these are some of the words from the people who are the experts. So what is the future of network marketing? Have you thought about it? So okay, I'll share with you a very interesting story. So for me, right, I joined USANA 6 years ago. And my mom has been in business for a long time. So I think the first event of USANA I attended was probably 8 years ago or even 10 years ago, where she was receiving an award and I was an audience below the stage clapping for her. And then when I was looking at USANA, I was looking at this business, I saw a lot of old people. Ignore of them, sir. I saw a lot of, not old people, older people. Okay, 长辈, I saw a lot of 长辈. I saw a lot of people who are just not like me, right? So at that time, I asked myself, and I told myself, I said, USANA is a great product. USANA is fantastic, but it's not for me. Because I'm young, because I am a graduate, I have a degree, I'm smart. So I have this arrogance in me, and I thought that this is not for me. I thought that this is for people who are a bit like auntie, and like, you know, housewife. I need to do very chillax and just do this for fun. So that was my mindset. But nowadays, do you know that the future of network marketing has changed tremendously over the years? Nowadays, right, what is it for? It's for people who are higher caliber. It's for the professionals. And it is for the younger people. Do you agree? Do you realize that nowadays, a lot of youngsters, right, don't do business, right? I believe in this room today, somehow we do have a lot of young people. So a lot of young people do business, right? But what is the major issue with doing business? The biggest hindrance, your first hindrance, what is it? No money, capital, no money, right? How? If you want to do business but no money, what do you do? How? Cannot do. Loan from bank. Loan from bank. Loan from your uncle. Loan from your father. What if you really have money and you are really someone who is very capable?
Get a job.
Then you are stuck. Then forever it's just
get part time.
Get a job and do this part time. Okay. Very smart. So that's the thing, right? A lot of young people want to do business, but they're stuck at step one, which is bolui, no money. You can't even start it. You don't even have. When I was 23, 24, my bank account only got $200. It's really, really sad. But I'm really very poor. At that age, like I can only the most luxurious meal I can eat is like ramen. And I feel like wow, $15 ramen is very good. So young people, a lot of them have big dreams, right? But money. So which is the place that can fulfill their dreams with no money? No marketing. Because in this industry, it doesn't discriminate. You don't have to have capital to start. And a lot of people who are succeeding in this industry nowadays are the young people. The young people and the professional ones. So you realize that especially in USANA, we attract a lot of professionals. People who are in the banking industry, a lot of teachers, we even have lawyers, doctors in the business owners. Right? So this is the future of network marketing and where it's headed to. So I always, nowadays when I share this business, I always share it to the professionals and people who are higher caliber. I look for people who are higher caliber because I believe that with their capabilities, it can be put into a better place and they can compress their success and achieve success faster than if they are just working in a full-time job. Alright, so now that we know that network marketing is a very good platform, how do we choose the right company? So, like I said, there are many, many companies out there. So personally, I have been to a lot of companies and I have been to a lot of talks. And I can tell you that experience is very interesting. So some talks is, I just can't sit through it. Because it's like a, I feel like it's like a, it's almost like they are being like a possessed. How many of you have been to some of some other talks? How many of you have been to? What was your experience?
Possessed.
Okay, I shall not name which companies, but there's some companies really gave me the impression that the people they are possessed, and it's very scary. And some companies, I don't like it that they exaggerate the product functionalities. There was, okay, actually, I just share with you a very random story. So there was one company I went to, and then I sat in the talk, and this uncle was giving a talk, okay? And he said, our company product is very good. Then I was like, okay, what about very good? He said, I have this customer, the person is blind. Then he took our products. Then the hospitals can close. Then immediately another guy, an uncle, also came up. I have a friend. Last time, he was in an accident. The car knocked him down in the hospital. And then going to die. 2 weeks, he stood up after taking our product. Oh, everybody clapped. So it's a bit weird, right? I don't know. I feel that people are more sophisticated nowadays. People who are smarter will not buy that. So for me, when I choose a company, right, I look at various factors. There's a various things I look at. Number one, I look at the first thing is the company's culture. Second, company's product range. Is the product even legit? Is the product even a unique product on its own? I look at the people in the company. So when I go to a company, I always look at who are the ones in that company. Right? So the first thing that I would like to share with you guys is that when you talk about network marketing, right, there's this page that's very important. This is called Direct Selling Association of Singapore, DSAS. So like I said, there are more than 200 companies in Singapore, but less than 20 companies are under DSAS. So this association helps to control and scrutinize all these companies who are registered and make sure that they are adhering to the right regulations. And USANA is under DSAS. So if you are interested, you can log on to their website and look at all the regulations and the companies which are listed under Direct Selling Association. So sometimes when my friends ask me about USANA, I say, oh, NLM, NLM. I say, no, it's Direct Selling. Go to DSAS. Go. Okay, let's talk about USANA. So, why did I choose USANA? There are a lot of reasons. The first reason, what's the first reason, do you know? The first reason, like I said just now, right? First reason, when you look at the company, is the company's culture. But before going to the company's culture, I look at who is the founder. The founder is very important. So in USANA, our founder is Dr. Michael Wentz. So he's a microbiologist and immunologist. So why USANA is so different from other companies is precisely because the founder, he is a scientist. He knows what is in his products. But many companies out there, the founder themselves are businessmen. So they started the business first and then they thought of a product to sell to run the business model. But USANA was the other way. So when Dr. Merriman's first created USANA, before that he actually had a laboratory called the Gao Laboratories. So during his time at this laboratory, right, he was doing cell research. So he was like very scientist in a lab and growing cells in a petri dish. Very boring, right? But he likes it. He really, really has passion for the cells. So he looks at the cells and he feed all these cells in a petri dish with good nutrients, good vitamins, good minerals, good antioxidants. And all his cells can last for a long time, healthy cells. So what was the change? Why did he create USANA Health Sciences? It's because of a personal reason. His father and his mother and his brother passed away because of cancer and heart attack. So at that point in time, he asked himself, since I'm an expert in cell nutrition and I can keep cells healthy, why am I stuck in the lab doing cell research? Why not I come out and create something to help people? And that was when USANA was born. So it was founded in 92 and now we are 26 years. Okay? So another thing about this company is that I like the fact that it has a span of many countries. So currently we are in 24 countries. So imagine this. Imagine when you start a business, right? If you're doing a traditional business, if you start a business, it's only within your current market. If you want to go to any other countries, you have to pay extra. You have to duplicate everything in other countries. But the beauty of USANA is that day one, when I am in USANA, I can expand my business to all the 24 countries. And that is amazing. It's seamlessly connected online. So all I need to do is, I can serve anybody, anywhere. So there was once I was in Melbourne. So this is very interesting, very funny story. So I was in Melbourne. I went there to attend Tony Robbins' talk at that time. I went there at an airport, and then I bought a taxi. And then the taxi driver, a big size, okay, he sit here. So I entered, and then I started chit-chatting with him. And then there was a very, very big jam. So we were stuck in a jam for about 2 hours. Very, very, very long, very long journey. So I asked myself, I said, since I'm stuck here for so long, why not I sell him product? Just kidding. So I thought, why not I make a new friend? So I started to chat with him and he asked me, he said, hey, because he was like, hey, a young lady, because I was very young at the time when I was in Melbourne, that was about 3 years ago. Yeah, and generally I look young. So he said, oh, young lady, are you here in Melbourne alone? I said, yeah, I'm here alone. So he said, are you here for a holiday or are you here for work? Then I said, I'm here for both. And he said, oh, you're here for work. What kind of work do you do? So I started to chit-chat with him. And I said that I am doing a business of wellness. So he asked me straight away. He said, wellness? Oh, he said, that kind where you know you can help people to lose weight. Then I looked at him, yeah, I can. And then he was like, oh, what kind of product? You think I can lose weight? Because he was a bit blunt. Then I said, yes, I think you can. So basically, we were stuck in the gym for 2 hours, and by the time I reached my hotel, right, it's 9 p.m, it's very dark. And then he told me, and he said that he wants to understand about my USANA business and my product. So I went up, I said, let me put my luggage, because all my documents are in my luggage. I put my luggage here, I come down and explain to you. So it was about 10 p.m, and in his car, in that yellow light, I was explaining the USANA to him. And guess what? He wants to join me. And immediately the next day, I asked him to meet me at the hotel lobby, online, sign him up. And he became one of my business associates. And then he built his business in London. I didn't do anything. So what I mean is that this business, it can go anywhere. All you need is to open your mouth and share. That's it. As simple as that. Okay? And another thing is that USANA is a publicly traded company in the NASDAQ. Yeah, this is something that's very important, especially for an auditor like me. Being a listed company makes a lot of difference and gives a lot more credibility. So just now, do you remember the product guy? So he is poison pills, and he said that wellness industry is booming, right? So you know what? Look at this. So this is something that's very interesting. Okay, let's do an experiment. Since everybody is a bit tired, let's all stand up. Stretch a bit. Okay. Now I'm going to do a dance. you know of someone who's close to you, it can be a friend or it can be a family member close to you who has diabetes. If you have this, sit down. Diabetes. Okay. Oh, actually, diabetes. Quite a lot of people have diabetes. Okay, how many of you in this room, right, you know of someone close to you who has had heart attack or heart problems, cardiac problems? Please sit down. Oh, so we have 2 survivors. Or 3, we have 3 survivors. Oh, we have 4 survivors. So, how many? Oh, you see, no, okay, we have 3. Oh, here. 1, okay. How many of you remains who are still standing, right? Okay, those who are still standing. Do you know of someone who has cancer? You can sit down if you have. So, actually, so what does this mean? What do you all get from this experiment? It's very scary, right? If you think about it, maybe we look around and then we laugh at this, but to be honest, it's very scary. Because this is what we call statistics. And we don't want to fall into the statistics of all these numbers. Last time cancer used to be for the older people. But nowadays, cancer is everywhere. It can happen to someone who's as young as 15 years old, or even to a kid. So it's really scary. So why is wellness industry booming is precisely because of this. Is that all these diseases behind, they are diseases that is not contagious, but it's called the lifestyle diseases. And these are things that we are getting more and more. And all these are caused also by things that we cannot prevent. Free radicals. So what are free radicals? Free radicals are caused by all these things, like for example, stress. These are things you cannot prevent, right? Can you say that, okay, I want to be anti-stress? Cannot, huh? Sometimes, you know, for ladies, very obvious, huh? Once you're stressed, you've got pimple already, right? Maybe for men also, huh? So, stress is something we cannot prevent. Can we prevent pollution? Cannot. Even if you are someone who say, oh, I'm very zen, I do yoga, I meditate, I also don't go to polluted place. But what do you eat? You still eat very healthy every day? It's very hard right nowadays. So even for me, I'm someone who's very conscious of what I eat. But I can tell you, right, there are days when I just want to eat that chicken rice. Don't stop me. Because you just want to have your craving, right? So these are things, there are days, right, that I just want to eat KFC. Very, very bad, right? But no choice. I just want to eat it. So these are things like, you know, all this diet, all this food that we have in front of us, right? No matter how hard we try to be clean, how hard we try to be healthy, eat our vegetables and fruits. Some people even go and buy organic, right? How many people here buy organic? Can I see? Who buys organic in this room? Nobody, yeah. Nobody, very good, don't buy organic. It's not worth it. Because I tell you, organic is just a word. A lot of people who think they're buying organic, right? Actually, the thing is not. It's not fully organic. It's impossible to have a fully organic thing unless you grow it in your own garden. It's not possible. So I don't buy organic at all. So all these things, right, it's impossible for us to really, really stay clear of free radicals. Which is why I always say, right, supplements, if they don't have enough antioxidants, is useless. There are some brands out there, they only have vitamins and minerals. It's not sufficient. What we need today is antioxidants. Because antioxidants will combat our free radicals. So the best way, so what is this? It looks like a pill, like a capsule. So the best way is to get our nutrients from supplements. So for USANA, right, this is called the Subsensus, which is also our flagship product. So in 2 bottles of this multivitamins, you can get your daily needs of all the nutrients that you will need from real food. So if people say, I want to eat real food. I say, sure, go and eat real food. Eat 80 banana. Cannot. It's not possible, right? So if people say, I only want to eat real food. food. I don't want to eat your this supplement. Then I say, sure, you can eat 80 banana. Then they say, huh, really, man? I must eat 80 banana. I say, yes. Then you must see how many eggs? 23 eggs. You know, you buy NTUC the eggs, one tray is only 10. 23 a day, huh? 1 week, you become a, don't know what, chicken or something. It's just crazy. It's not possible. So, taking supplements, right, why is it the best way? It's not because of the fact that, oh, it's good. It's actually because it's very, very convenient. And it's measurable. And do you know that some people say, oh, I'm very healthy, I take orange every day, one orange a day. But the question is, where is your orange from? India, China, Africa, Europe? Do you know all these oranges from different countries, different soil? Vitamin C content is so different. So all these things are what I always tell my friends, that the only way and the best way in today's world is to take supplements, because you have no choice really. It's the easiest way, most convenient way. But of course, you buy already, you must eat. Some people, right, buy but don't eat. They think that just by buying it, putting it in the home, that they'll be healthy. But it will not happen, right? You must eat it regularly. So in USANA, there are three range of products. The first range is the supplements. So besides self-censure, these are what we call the optimizers. So everybody has different health needs, right? So maybe she wants to have better skin. Maybe he wants to have more energy. Maybe he wants to lower his blood cholesterol. So optimizers come into play. Today, we will not go through all the product's functionalities. If you are interested, you can ask your friend to share with you more details. The second range of product is, before that, we have this thing which is very special. It's called My Health Pack. So USANA is the only company in the whole world who has customized nutrition. So this is what I call for the lazy people and for the forgetful ones. So you just order a box and it comes in a 28-day supply, and every day you just put out 2 sachets. The second range of product we have is the weight loss program. So how many of you here don't mind losing some weight? Don't mind, don't say you want, but you don't mind. Don't mind. I also don't mind. I don't mind losing some weight, right? So this smart shape, right, is my personal favorite. Are you interested to see how much I've changed with my smart shape? Yes. Yes, okay, I'll show you. So, no sound. encourage me. So, it is not easy, you know? Graduate is not easy, right?
Yeah,
very difficult. Very difficult, so I show you my. Wow. But I tell you, to be honest, this is not by my smart shape alone. If this is smart shape, you have abs. Must go to the gym. But my smart shape is very, very good replacement meal if you want to lose off your weight before you tone up. So I'll recommend this to all my friends who want to lose weight. For me, it's my everyday breakfast. And you can choose your own flavor, your own foods that you want. Alright? And of course, the last range is our skincare. So there are many, many ladies out there who want to better skin, right? And not even the men, also very vain. The men also have better skin, right? So CeraVe skincare is a range of products where it can really give our skin younger skin and more glowing skin. So USANA is in fact very easy. It's only 3 range of products, 3 things. Everything is in 1 paper. Some companies I've been to, their product catalog is a stack. You open until there. 300 products. How you sell? You cannot focus, right? So this is another thing. USANA is a very focused company, right? So now I'm going to share a bit more details on why this company is so special. So this is a picture of USANA's headquarters in the US. And USANA's unique point is that everything manufactured here, all the way from raw materials, are all in-house. There is no outsourced steps in USANA's facility. And this is an award, it's called Best of State Award. The state that we are in is Utah, Salt Lake City. So in Utah, there are more than 200 over companies, but we started actually as number one for consecutively 13 years. Right? So that's very, very amazing. And this is a book that I would like to get everybody to, if you want, you can go and purchase this book from Kinokuniya, Amazon, or in Singapore's National Library, you can borrow this book. So this book is an independent third party review where they compare different kind of multivitamins in the market, on shelves, by retail, by direct selling, or inside. So yeah, I can borrow this book there. So this is the book. So this is already the sixth edition, and this book is being republished every few years because the scientists always have new research that they will add into the compilation. So I would strongly advise everyone to get this book to really read through and understand more about supplements. Alright? Okay, another thing that I would like to say is that this is something that I personally feel is the most important. USANA is the only company out there with a potency guarantee stamp. And this thing in the middle is the founder's signature. So this is not a designer, not like a art, it's not art. It's Dr. Myron Wen's signature. So he signed on every single bottle of our USANA products. What does this mean? I'll give you a very simple example. Let's say today you go and buy chicken rice. So today you buy chicken rice. Then when the chicken rice, the picture on the chicken rice, they have 5 pieces of chicken rice. Then when it's served to you, it has 3 pieces. How you feel?
Cheated.
But if they give you 6 pieces, how you feel? Better. Okay, the thing here is they give you 3 pieces or 6 pieces, both wrong. Because their picture is 5 pieces, right? So this is what we call by potency guarantee. So I'll give you a very lame example. In supplements industry, it's very scary. Why? Because supplements is food. We are not drugs. So you know when you take medication, 1 mg difference, you might die. Right now. Like overdose of medicine, 1 mg whatever, or you eat too much, die. But supplements, right, you eat too much, you might not die. But you might slowly have issues. So recently there's a case, if you Google it online, recently there's a case of this product starts with G, and with C. You all know which product. So they have this product, it's called Ginseng Herbal Plus. Very obvious really, right? So they have this thing called Ginseng Herbal Plus. So if you go to the shop and you buy a product called Ginseng Herbal Plus, what do you think is inside?
Ginseng,
right? But when they went to take the pills in the lab test, 0% ginseng. Zero. It's all plum and rice powder. You can search this online. Okay, it's not I say. It's real. It's a real news. But when this happened, this company is not being sued. What they are required to do is only to take the product off the shelf. That's it. The reason is because this product is under category of food supplements. That's the problem. So a lot of people, they don't understand. They think that, wow, whatever I buy, especially if I buy on the shelf, it must be good. Wrong. Okay? So for me, I only trust because there's really a potency guarantee stamp and a signature on that. In most companies, if you can go to Watson's, go and look at all the shelves, all the product. Very few companies even guarantee potency. And no companies will go and sign on the bottle. Because in US, anything you sign is a contract. So this is also the reason why in USANA we are listed inside Doctor's Reference Book. And also we are now the official supplement sponsor for more than 4,000 Olympic players worldwide. And you know in China, how many of you know this news? So in China, the whole of China's Olympic group, the China Sports Bureau, is using USANA product. So you can also search this online. And they have this logo, it's a red and yellow logo. That's a China Sports Bureau logo. So that logo is stamped on each and every of USANA's product in China. So that's something that's really a lot of confidence given to USANA products. So whenever I tell my friends, I say you can go and eat any brands you want. But the most important thing is, if this product is not good, it's useless, never mind. But if this product has toxicity that goes into your liver, into your kidney, then it's a big problem. Then the next 3 years, 5 years, something happens, then you will not be able to tell today. You will only be revealed in later years, right? So these are the reason why for me when it comes to supplements, right, I pay special attention to all these guarantees. Alright, let's take a look at a video of this Olympic athlete's testimony. Can I have the lights off? Thank you.
To do that, you need to be fueling your body with the best of the best.
If I don't put the right things into my body, it won't perform when I ask it to.
I've worked so hard to get to where I am today, and I'm not about to risk it on a supplement that I don't trust, so I choose your son. So what are you afraid of? Those feelings are made of. Get in the game, you're moving to fame, so then what you made of? For anyone asking who is the best, we put in our hands up. Why do I take USANA? Because USANA's the best.
I know it's clean, I know it's safe. I can't chance my career and my reputation on a product that I don't trust.
You know, that's also a reason why you have so many athletes on USANA. We know what it takes to be reaching the top. Tell me to stop, mark down, mark down.
We know what it takes to be reaching the top. I trust USANA because...
I trust USANA.
I trust USANA.
Trust, trust.
I trust USANA because it's safe, it makes me feel good.
I don't have to worry about what I'm taking.
I know that I'm getting everything I need.
It's about the products.
Yeah. So the most important is trust, right, when it comes to supplements, right? Okay, so with that, I'll go on to the next part about the income. Right, I'll quickly go through this part. So in USANA, right, we know that it's a good product, it's a good business, but how do we earn extra income from it? So there are 6 ways of earning, but the most important is actually the weekly commissions. So of course there's retail sales. Retail means that you buy and you sell. Buy at a cost and you sell at another cost, so you earn the margin in between. Incentive program. Who would like to go for free trips? Everyone, right, now holiday. Imagine going for holiday for free with your loved ones. So you sign up, you have a lot of incentive trips, and all these trips are easily attainable in your goal setting. Weekly commission and leadership bonus, later I'll show you on another chart. So for details of how this really, really works, right, I would suggest you to ask your friend who has brought you here to explain more details for you. So this is the chart, all the earnings of the, it's very transparent. So all the earnings of the different ranks of USANA is all here. So what you see is, for example, let's take a look at level one, it's called a goal director. So goal director basic income is US, this is US dollars. And this is weekly USD. In USANA, the exchange rate we use is 1.42. So market right now is 1.32. So it's already a very big forex gain, right? So for goal director, which is level one of USANA, basic commission is $1,000 per week. Extra bonus is 175. Total, on average, is about 8K SGD per month. So let's not look at all these things a lot. I know a lot of numbers. Some people are very allergic to numbers, right? You feel very giddy. But let me summarize for you. This is just better than your job, to be honest. When I first looked at it, I was working as an auditor. I was like, oh my god, level one, I was like level one 8K. Wow. In audit, I have to work 10 years to get to 8K. And these 10 years, I have to suffer, you know. I really have to brush away all the other colleagues or whatever and climb, and then I can become 8K. But in USANA, the beauty of this business is that all these ranks right here, there is no limitation. As long as you are able to achieve that, you can become any rank you want. In a corporate ladder, you can only have one manager, right? If the manager doesn't go away, you will never be able to be there, right? But in USANA, it doesn't mean that, oh, in Singapore, we only can have 3 diamond director. You can have 30, you can have 300, up to you. So this is the beauty of this business. So this chart, if you want to take a picture, you can. But if you don't want to, you can also Google online, okay? Alright, so before I end, right, I'm going to invite two special guests today who wants to share with us their own Lusana journey. Yeah, so before inviting them, this is a picture of me on a holiday. I always say this, but actually it's not me. But it really looks like me. So I just don't know why. So I went online to look for a picture, and then I found this, and then I was like, oh my god, is that me? But actually it's not. But I summarize Lusana in three short phrases. A phone in hand, a cup of coffee, conquering 24 countries. So with that, I end my sharing today, and I'll pass the time now to our two special sharers today. So let us invite